For many trained at Millville, the departure overseas came quickly. Now they would be tested in combat and find out how effective their training at the airfield had been.
I learned so much from another man's mistakes. Whenever we had a crash or something, I used to dig to find out what happened, so it wouldn't happen to me. And I would pass that on to somebody.
The danger was ever present, but it never occupied our minds too much, as far as I could tell. Matter of fact, sometimes the bad weather was more dangerous than the German fighters.
Pilots found themselves tested in different ways, but their training proved invaluable. MILLVILLE squadrons significantly helped the Allied campaign. The capabilities of the P-47 Thunderbolt were realized quickly.
Thunderbolt was a superb airplane. First of all, the plane was easy to fly, easy to handle. There weren't a lot of things that you had to be watching all the time.
And with 850 caliber guns, they converged at about 650 or 700 feet in front of the airplane. If you caught a German truck in there, a 3 or 4 second burst from the 8 guns, you would totally tear that truck apart. The Germans had great respect for the P-47 because of its firepower.
And it was very accurate in the bomb runs. You know, after I had 4 or 5 practice runs, I got so I could pick the target and hit it almost every time. And in fact, before I was wounded, I had a record. I had 14 direct hits on bridges. And I felt pretty good about that.
Aerial combat required personal, quick decisions, often with life or death consequences.
I can't explain the feeling. You become very cool, but you're scared to death, and you wind up with sweat up there on you because you think you can be killed at any minute. I should have been killed a couple times.
I was partially blacked out, grayed out, and I could see the ground coming up at me at a fantastic rate. When I looked down, I saw the tops of trees on both sides of me. So I didn't miss the ground by more than about maybe 20, 30 feet. And but for the grace of God, I'd have been buried in that airfield.
I felt the airplane shudder when I got hit. The cockpit was full of smoke. And the only thing I disconnected was the seatbelt, jettisoned the canopy, went over the side. I cleared the airplane and the airplane exploded before I popped my parachute. Pretty soon they had me surrounded. So I finally put my pistol away and stood up, my hands up. And the first thing one of the Germans said to me in English, "For you, the war is over."
The unmistakable prominence of MILLVILLE's Wall of Remembrance in the center of town is a constant reminder of what went on here during the war. The wall is dedicated to the 14 pilots who died training at MILLVILLE and commemorates the town's contribution to aviation history. Below the mural stands another monument dedicated to a pilot who gave his life, MILLVILLE-born Marty Garten. Marty had been a high school football star and a scholarship awardee before becoming a pilot. He trained in Florida and had been flying missions out of England until he was shot down over German territory. Garten is remembered by the monument created by the P-47 Pilots Association. His sacrifice a lasting reminder of yet another way the city contributed to the war effort. As in so many places across the country, young men were taken away and never came back.